China desperately needs Australian iron ore, and Australia can iron them out neatly with this advantage. Relations between China and Australia have been going south ever since Australia strongly stood up for its democratic values and called for an international probe into the origins of the COVID-19 pandemic in the Hubei province of China. Chinese state media Global Times even said, "Australia is a bit like chewing gum stuck on the sole of China's shoes. Sometimes you have to find a stone to rub it off." Clearly, China wants to punish Canberra for leading the global backlash against Beijing. Xi Jinping has imposed tariffs on Australian barley and banned the import of meat from 4 Australian abattoirs. But guess what? The Chinese president cannot really punish Australia because the dragon cannot target the biggest import commodity from down under, and that is iron ore. Iron ore imports and steel production are at the core of China's plan of an economic revival, and China imports over 60% of its iron ore from Australia. China is heavily dependent on Australian iron ore, and this is not going to stop anytime soon. You see, China has a massive plan to revive its economy, and that needs steel. This means that China's road to economic revival goes through Australia. For China to punish Australia, China itself will have to forego its superpower ambitions. Local governments in China are expected to issue so-called special bonds to the tune of $565 billion. China plans to come out of the economic slump that it finds itself in by splurging these proceeds on infrastructure development, be it rail, roads, or airports. With this, it intends to cover for the jobs lost as well. Numerous Chinese provinces, including Shanghai and Beijing, have announced grand plans for the development of massive infrastructure projects. The total infrastructure investment in the People's Republic of China is expected to hit a whopping $4.8 trillion. Infrastructure, and hence steel, is at the core of all of China's urgent needs. This is why, while Australian agricultural commodities have met with tariffs from Beijing, Australia's energy and natural resource exports have been spared. According to Wood Mackenzie, Australia's iron ore exports to China have increased by 8% on a year-to-date basis compared to last year. China is the world's biggest iron ore consumer and also the world's biggest steel producer. It manufactures 51% of the world's steel, a strategic good that is needed for almost everything from cutlery to aircraft, tankers, and surgical instruments. We have talked about this in one of our videos. Even apart from its ambitions to spend heavily on infrastructure for reviving its economy, China wouldn't want to lose its undisputed global leadership in producing steel, which reached 930 million metric tons in the year 2018. The Asia-Pacific Vice Chairman for Energy at Wood Mackenzie, however, says that Australian iron ore is critical to the Chinese economy. The reason is simple. Australia is the biggest producer and exporter of iron ore. And according to the World Steel Association, Australia managed 60% of the world's total iron ore shipments last year. While China imports 60% of its iron ore from Australia, the next big producer, Brazil, lags far behind Australia and accounted for 23% of the world's total seaborne iron ore last year. As per Wood Mackenzie, Brazil's iron ore exports are set to dip by 4% this year due to the pandemic, wet weather, and a recent mining accident in the country. China has few alternatives when it comes to finding an iron ore source, and thus it is unable to settle scores with Canberra even when it really wants to. Last month, a China Iron and Steel Association executive said that China could swap Australian for African iron ore, but there would be a lag for 4 to 5 years before the dragon can tap into the African deposits. To revive its economy, which shrank by 6.8% in the first quarter this year, China has no choice but to turn to the Aussies. Meanwhile, in Australia, a pertinent question is being asked. Why don't we just make our own steel? The Australian political leadership seems confident. Prime Minister Scott Morrison made it clear that he would not be intimidated by Beijing's coercion and said, "We are an open trading nation, mate. But I'm never going to trade our values in response to coercion from wherever it comes." Morrison is truly standing up for, quote-unquote, our values, that is democracy and transparency, both of which are alien to China. In fact, China doesn't have many options, but Australia does have options, and it can look at diversifying its iron ore markets. Recently, a report by Grattan Institute concluded that a new Australian green steel industry could create tens of thousands of jobs in regional areas. This means that Australia could consider consuming more and more iron ore in a new green steel industry instead of exporting it to China. Now, it certainly looks like Australia has gripped the dragon by the neck, and there is nothing China can do about it, at least for now.